Well, you'd think, wouldn't you, that the trick to producing the world's finest wool would be happy, free-range sheep, right? Sorry, not quite right. In fact, quite wrong. And in the eyes of the law, the appalling practice used on some farms, all in the name of fashion, is perfectly okay. Here's 6.30's environment reporter, Emily Rice.
Certainly not common farming practice, this operation is what animal welfare groups refer to as a battery sheep factory. It's an Australian ultra-fine wool shed where sheep are held in individual pens long-term. They're fed a limited diet to promote the growth of the fine micron fleece and dressed in nylon coats to protect the wool from dirt.
They're going to be there every day, every night, week after week, years on end. Nothing to do except to pace around that tiny little couple of metres that they've got on wooden slats. It's terrible. It's cruel.
Footage of the practice has been provided exclusively to 6.30 by Animals Australia, which says confining livestock causes frustration and distress.
They're repetitively doing things because there's nothing else to do. Doing circuits, turning round and round. They may be chewing on the bars of the pen. Some of them have been seen chewing repeatedly on the feed bin that's in their pen. They might pace, that is, go backwards and forwards, backwards and forwards.
Activists insist the footage also proves the sheep are suffering physically. It is cheaper to run sheep free range than those in sheds and hand fed. But ultra fine wool is lucrative. A bale sells for around $20,000 compared with fleeces from flocks of sheep in the paddock. They sell for around $2,500 a bale. Ultra fine is regarded as the world's most prestigious wool fibre and it's blended with silk and cashmere to create luxury fashion garments.
It's about the wool and trying to keep it in a state so that they'll get more and more money for it.
Scientist Professor Paul Hemsworth has been studying housed sheep and says repetitive behaviour may not necessarily be caused by intensive housing, but rather by diet.
We see similar abnormal behaviours in poultry, in horses, for example. When we feed them a very concentrated diet where they have a less opportunity to forage, less opportunity to search for their feed.
He says the impact of keeping sheep indoors can only be accurately assessed by the use of hidden cameras to eliminate human disturbance on their behaviour.
And you would need to look at their behaviour throughout the entire day to really get a reliable measure of how they're behaving. I don't think that it's inherently bad to house animals indoors as long as you meet their requirements.
Wool producers have provided their own footage, which they say shows the hands-on care shedded sheep receive. Less than 1% of the Australian flock is kept indoors and any signs of a sheep in distress would be evident in its fleece.
It will get a break in the wool, and when you get a break in the wool, you can get up to a 60% discount for your product. You actually can't afford to have bad health with your sheep. You can't afford not to have the good welfare.
Producers also follow a code of conduct and fund research into animal welfare.
If there's a possible improvement in any of the technologies, any of the methods, techniques that we use, we will find that and we will use it.
But Animals Australia won't stop the fight and want the so-called sheep factories outlawed.
To make it an offence to keep a sheep in a barren battery pen.
That's definitely one to think about.